You fit into our family right away and so well. And really, truly, from that day, I knew that Brittany and Luke had something special and that this was something that was going to last forever. When Brittany called me to tell me that she was engaged, I wasn't surprised, but I was so overjoyed and just could not wait to get started on the planning and what was going to lead us to this day. It is amazing to add another very handsome and fun brother who is willing to put up with us Barbie girls, because we all know we are a handful. I mean, this day has been so amazing. You guys deserve it. And just hurry up and make me some nieces and nephews. Cheers, you guys. Even though we may be hopeless, hearts just passing through. Every bone screaming. There's a lot of qualities I admire about Brittany, but the biggest quality I admire the most is that she took a leap of faith and she chased her dreams. She left her family. All of those chances and risks that she took led her to her person, which is Luke. And when I first met him, he was happy as a clam at high tide, and you were just an absolute peach, and I knew that you were the one for her. Because if you guys can get through 3,000 miles in a Honda Civic with two cats, you'll do fine raising kids. To Mr. and Mrs. Gott, I love you guys so much, and I wish you a lifetime of happiness.
Luke, thank you for being such a stable force in my life, a great friend, and even better brother. Brittany, I think we all agree that you're amazingly stunning this evening, and Luke has won the lottery. Brittany and Luke, tonight we celebrate you. We all wish you a lifetime of happiness, love, health, success, and laughter. May you continue to find humor in the bad and appreciation for the good. May your friendship continue to grow throughout all the years to come. Cheers. Made for loving you. Even though we may be hopeless, hearts just passing through. Every bone screaming, I don't know what we should do. All I know is, darling, I was made for loving you.
Like a fantasy existing in some far off place has finally arrived. I've been thinking about this day since we first met. I can still see your handsome face standing there as I sat nervously in my car, reapplying my lipstick, knowing deep down in my gut you'd be the one. Since that day, you've provided me with so much support, laughter, spontaneity, kindness, and love. You are my comfort and my peace. You make me feel beautiful, cherished, and strong. I love your quirky humor and how sensitive and thoughtful you are. I love how observant you are of everything and your attention to detail with every kind gesture you do for me. I love how our rides in the Jeep always feel like an adventure. I love the way you treat our cats as if they're children, and I admire your love for family and your willingness to put everyone's happiness before your own. This is a short list of qualities that I don't take for granted. These are the things that make me hold you a little closer and love you even deeper. I promise to try to always put the Nutribullet away after every use. I promise to support you, dream with you, and build with you, to be your friend and confidant. I promise to never stop getting to know you, laugh even when you're the only one who thinks it's funny. I promise to be your biggest fan and to be there even when times aren't easy. Lastly, I promise to continue to let this list grow. Love, your wife, Brittany.
Brittany, my love, here we are, just as we envisioned. A little over a year ago, I got down on one knee, knowing our lives were about to change forever. Through our journeys, I have found you can mesmerize me with just one look. You calm me with your touch and make me complete by my side. You have taught me what true love really is. Today I promise to be your lover, companion, and best friend. Through health and sickness, through sorrows and success, I pledge my life and devotion to loving you as we can continue our journey as one. I love you always and
promise
forever.
Me you'll always be happy by my side. I promise to sing to you when all the music dies. And say hello in this cafe, say you will. Say you will. Marry me.
To a woman, love means that she feels cherished and adored by her husband. She is number one, above anyone or anything. This is what I call the love principle, because women have a real need to feel deeply loved and cherished, not a want, but a need. And to a man, love means that he feels respected and appreciated for who he is and for what he does, without feeling like anyone's trying to change or fix him. This is what I call the respect principle, because men have a real need, not a want, but a need to feel respected, appreciated, and even a little admired. A wise man once said, the key to motivating your spouse is found in discovering what their deepest need is, then doing what you can to meet that need. For a woman, her need is to feel deeply loved. And when her husband meets her need for love, it naturally motivates her to meet his need for respect. And when a wife does everything she can to meet a husband's need for respect, it naturally motivates him to show her the love that her heart desperately cries out for. Do you, Luke, take Brittany, whom you hold by the hand, to be your lawfully wedded wife, to love, honor, and cherish for richer or poorer, in sickness and in health, through good times and bad, forsaking all others to cleave to her only, and to cleave means to hold tightly, so long as you both shall live? If so, answer, I do.
I do.
And do you, Brittany, take Luke, whom you hold by the hand, to be your lawfully wedded husband, to love, honor, and cherish for richer or poorer, in sickness and in health, in good times and bad, forsaking all others, to cleave to him only, so long as you both shall live? If so, answer, I do.
I do.
I'm so in love with you, and I hope you know, darling, your love is more than worth its weight in gold. We've come so far, my dear, look how we've grown, and I want to stay with you until we're great old. Just say you won't let go.
Well, by the power vested in me by the state of just California, I now pronounce you husband and wife. You may now kiss your bride. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you for the very first time, Mr. and Mrs. Luke and Brittany Gott.
I'm gonna love you till my lungs give out. I promise till death we part like in our vows. The sorrow that's over you, now everybody knows that it's just you and me to a great load. Just say you won't let go. 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 Just say you won't let go.
there's something going on between you and me. We've been playing games that friends don't play. I know, cause my friends don't look that way. If everyone left, I know you stay. And I know, I know it's late.
Break.